The Holy Quran is the final revelation of God Almighty. It is the unadulterated word of God that has not been edited since the time it was revealed, some 1400 years ago. Allah states in the Quran, "And we have made the sky a well-protected canopy, still they turn away from its signs." Surah 21, verse 32. The Quran states that the sky is a well-guarded canopy or roof. But how? At the night you can see stars, satellites, and other celestial bodies. But what you do not see is the complexity of our atmosphere. Let's see what modern science has to say. The atmosphere we live in is an ocean of gases and particles that envelops the Earth. It can be as much as 10,000 kilometers thick. This seemingly soft sea of invisible gases can act like a ceiling harder than a wall of stone or steel. Let's learn four ways we know in which the sky protects planet Earth and its inhabitants. The sky protects the world from meteors and meteorites. Millions of these stones make it to our upper atmosphere every day. Our atmosphere acts as a protective shield because of its sheer thickness, slowing down these missiles and disintegrating them into oblivion. The sheer friction generates enough heat to evaporate these extremely hard rocks. Life as we know it would not be possible without this protection. The Earth's surface would be like the Moon, Mercury, or Mars, full of holes and craters. This fact was learned only recently as a result of our exploration of other celestial bodies. The upper atmosphere acts like a protective shield, bouncing off harmful radiation back into space. Some energy gets through, but most of it is absorbed as a result of interaction with molecules in the atmosphere. The ozone layer in the upper atmosphere inhibits the ultraviolet radiation of the sun from reaching us. All life would disappear without this shield and filter. Beyond the atmosphere of gas, there is an invisible layer called the Van Allen belts. These are the result of the strong magnetic field of the planet. The direction of this magnetic field is such that harmful particles from space get deflected towards the poles or beyond and never reach the surface. Life on Earth would be impossible without the Van Allen belts. These belts ward off high-energy charged particles and plasma winds from space, which would otherwise pass through our atmosphere without much resistance. Without these belts, we would be bombarded with lethal doses of radiation. The gigantic greenhouse. The average temperature in space is minus 270 degrees Celsius. This is close to absolute zero. The atmosphere turns our Earth into a greenhouse that traps heat from the sun and maintains chemical activity and thus life. Without the atmosphere, energy from the sun would bounce back into space. Thanks to our atmosphere, heat is distributed. A single region cannot overheat, nor do regions in shade freeze beyond repair. We and everything would fry or freeze without the atmosphere. The convection of air in the atmosphere is what makes the vast majority of our landmass habitable. Without this, regions on equator would overheat, while places closer to the poles would remain frozen permanently. Allah has made the atmosphere as He willed, as a means of protection. The real protector is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has stated several places in the Quran that He is the one who created the sky. In addition, He has explicitly asked us to ponder on the signs in the heavens. The fact that the sky offers protection was mentioned 1400 years ago to a people living in the middle of the desert at the fringes of civilization. So how could the man named Muhammad have come up with such powerful statements that we have only been able to verify recently? And how could he have come up with so many of them? One cannot but accept the Quran as the divine revelation of the mighty creator of us all. That creator is the one and the only, Allah Almighty.